एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल डाइट लर्निंग। होप यू ऑल आर प्रिपेयरिंग वेल। इफ यू हैवंट सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल येट, देन काइंडली सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू ज्वाइन द टेलीग्राम चैनल व्हिच आई हैव पिन्ड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स। सो इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद यू अबाउट नेचुरल फाइबर एंड इट्स टाइप विद डिटेल एक्सप्लेनेशन। सो डोंट लीव द वीडियो इन बिटवीन, काइंडली वॉच द वीडियो टिल एंड। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। Firstly, we will discuss about classification of natural fiber in the part 1 of this video, that is textile from scratch. I have already discussed in detail about natural and synthetic fiber. So in this video, we will look after types of natural fiber. First one is bast fiber. Bast fiber is also known as phloem fiber or skin fiber. Bast fiber is collected from the phloem or skin of the dicotyledons plant. Bast fiber are found in the stem of plant, providing the plant its strength. Why bast fiber is also known as phloem fiber or skin fiber? Because bast fiber is collected from the phloem tissues of the plants. This is the part of plant. Here you can clearly see the bast fiber, which looks like the skin of a plant. Now we will study about type of fiber collected from the bast part of a plant. First one is jute fiber. Jute is one of the cheapest natural fibers. Jute fibers are composed primarily of cellulose, a major component of plant fiber, and lignin, a major component of wood fiber. So we can say jute fiber is a combination of cellulose and lignin, that is partially a textile fiber and partially a wood. Let's make it more clear. Jute fibers are totally biodegradable in nature and recyclable material, that is environment friendly material. Jute is used chiefly to make cloth for wrapping bales of raw cotton. Now this is the longitudinal view of jute fiber and this is the cross sectional view of jute fiber. In longitudinal view, there is crosswise marks called nodes on joint, and in the cross-sectional view, the fibers have a small central canal similar to lumen in cotton. Now, this is the actual jute fiber. Now, we'll talk about hemp fiber. Hemp is also one of the bast fiber known from ancient time. It has been conducted over many centuries for end users, from textile, rope and sail cloth to mattresses for industrial product in the modern age. It is one of the fastest growing biomasses. The hemp fiber or industrial hemp is obtained from the outer layer or bast of the cannabis. Hemp fiber are separated from the bark through a process which is called retting. Hemp fiber have been used for centuries to manufacture clothes, bags, shoes, paper, building material and insulation purposes. Here is the longitudinal and cross-sectional view of hemp fiber. It is only visible under microscope. In longitudinal view, smooth and cylindrical with cross marking nodes are appeared, and in the cross sectional view, it is partly polygonal. This is the actual hemp fiber. It looks like this. Now we'll talk about leaf fiber. Leaf fibers are hard fibers, are a type of plant fiber mainly used for cordage producing rope. They are the toughest of the plant fiber, which is most likely due to their increased lignin content when compared to the other group of plant fiber. This leaf fiber are hard, coarse fiber obtained from leaf of monocotyledons plant. They are the toughest just because of their increased lignin content. Now, what do we mean by this lignin content? Lignin is a complex organic polymer deposited in the cell wall of many plants, making them rigid and woody. दिस इज हाउ फाइबर्स आर बीन एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द प्लांट. इन द लीफ फाइबर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सीसल फाइबर. सीसल फाइबर इज अ हार्ड फाइबर एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द लीव्स ऑफ द सीसल प्लांट एगेव सीसालाना. As we have seen already, all the leaf fibers are hard in nature because of their increased lignin content. Sisal fiber is one of the most widely used natural fiber and is very easily cultivated. Actually, all vegetable fibers are most widely used. This is the sisal fiber. Now we'll talk about the banana fiber. Banana fiber is a natural fiber with high strength which can be blended easily with cotton fiber or other synthetic fibers to produce blended fabric and textile. Banana paper is versatile as it is waterproof and stronger than wood pulp paper, meaning it can be used in packaging and even as a basis for building materials. This banana fiber is high in strength and can be easily blended with cotton or man-made fibers. This fiber is waterproof also, that's why it is also used in packaging as well as basis for other building materials. Now we'll look into the whole process that convert a raw banana plant into a usable banana fabric. So first one is banana plant. This is a banana plant and the fibers are being extracted from this plant. In order to create this plant fiber, the trunk of the tree is soaked in the nearby rivers for softening because this fiber is too hard to process at it as. Then the fibers are extracted either by stripping machine or by hand and then knotted into yarn. Simply, you can say firstly fiber is being extracted from the banana plant, then the stalk cutting process is there, then the fibers are being converted into pulp and this pulp make the banana fiber, and when the banana fiber is there, the banana fiber is converted into yarn, and this yarn when woven or spun, it makes the banana fabric. Let's go into depth. I have added one more slide for more understanding of the topic. How is banana fabric made? First one is separation. The fibers in banana peels and stem must be separated from the non-usable component. As you can see, first part is separation. We separate the fibers from the banana peels and stem. Second process is bunching and drying. The fibers are bunched together and dried with the inner and outer fibers commonly kept together. Bunching you can see making clusters or clubbing the fiber and then exposed to sunlight for drying from inner and outer surface. Next process is dividing into groups. Once dry, the fibers are separated into quality-based group with A being the best. After drying, we sort the fiber like based on the quality. This process is as similar as we do sorting and grading in wool fiber also. Next one is spinning and weaving. The separated fibers are then spun into yarn. The yarn is treated and dyed and it is woven into product. Finally, the fibers are ready to spun and weave into yarn. So guys, thank you so much. If you like the video, please press the like button and don't forget to subscribe the channel. For more updates, join Telegram channel. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care. Stay healthy.